I feel this exhibition is very contemporary. Mm-hmm. It doesn't feel like it's just a history lesson. You know, it feels like something that's extremely relevant to today. And I think that, I hope that young people will come here in droves, because I think there's so much to learn about how an architect constantly reinvents themselves and is willing to try a new high wire act. You know, I see our father in this exhibition as being like an acrobat. He's stepping out yet again. I'll try something totally new. I don't know how to do this trick yet. Let me try to figure it out. You're feeling that here. And that takes a huge amount of courage and just fearlessness to try again. You know, people nowadays, they find a gimmick, they find a thing they do, and they just keep doing it. Mm-hmm. And I'm just saying in architecture, I think in a lot of things, we're sort of encouraged, even artistically. You find something that works, you know, do part two, do it again. A painting, do the same thing. But
Are
Lou,
you going to do my architect part two?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Never. No. And I think, I mean, one of the great things about this exhibition is you really get the sense of the struggle that it was for him to come up with something, to really get to the level where he was happy, or even partially happy. And so when I'm looking at these DACA models, the models of the roof structure, how many times he tried, you know, and the roof, he really was not fully resolved with it, partly because the structure couldn't quite hold up the roof he wanted, the higher roof, so it had to get lower. And he was really concerned with that. And I remember as a little boy seeing him working on that in the office and really puzzling over, how can I make this something that's going to be good enough? And so I guess, you know, walking through this exhibition, I'm feeling again that one of the things I love about DACA, especially today anyway, is that the struggle and the passion is all there, and it's represented in this, you know, in this wonderful show. So today I'm very much in love with DACA. So.
I have to say, I have not been to DACA or Ahmedabad, so if I were to go there, it's possible that I would say that DACA would be my favorite building.
But right now,
the building I think I've spent the most spiritual connection with is the Kimball Art Museum. I've spent a lot of time there. One of the times that I was there, I was ill with something, and I had a very bad headache, and I didn't feel well. And I was in the building for an hour, and I was cured. It's a beautiful space. There's something about the way the molecules are in that space. It is just so perfect and so calming. It's very beautiful. And he made the comment that when he was drawing the building, he felt someone else's hand was doing it. I think he felt a direct, and I take this to mean, you know, like not so much God as a sort of connection with a universal power that enabled him to do what he at that time thought was the best building that he did.
We are here not only to think about Kahn and to celebrate his work, but for me, I'm also here standing in front of you on behalf of the NAI to celebrate architecture in general. When do you discover that you want to dedicate your life to architecture? Is it when you decide to pursue architecture as a profession and for a livelihood? Or is it when you opt to study architecture at college? Is it when you enjoy the pleasure to create as a boy or girl?
Sometimes I feel like I am leaving life behind. My hands are moving faster, moving of my mind. Thoughts and generations of my dreams are yet unborn. I hope that I will find them before my moving gets too warm. If only I could live to see the dawning of the dawn.
To express is to drive. And when you want to give something presence, you have to consult nature. And there is where design comes in. If you think of brick, for instance, you say to brick, what do you want, brick? And brick says to you, I like an arch. And if you say to brick, look, marshes are expensive, and I can use a concrete lintel over you, what do you think of that, brick? Brick says, I like an arch. And it's important, you see, that you honor the material which you use.
That actually a problem that I had with Kahn, in the sense that for me, this enigmatic architect was always a little bit too high up, close to heaven, to really get hold of. So that's why, that's part of my irritation with Kahn, and I'm very happy that this this exhibition, this preparation of this exhibition, made it possible for me to come a little closer to this secret. And I really think I no longer see him that much of as a mystic figure who remains somehow embedded in the mystery of his utterings, because I see those sentences that some of them have become very famous as really sort of a poetic kind of attempts at summing up basic truths in architecture. And in fact, it's like a sport. At some point, I imagine that he began to develop the habit also as a teacher in the studio to try to really bring ideas together and put them in a nutshell, and came to formulas that are ultimately extremely poetic.
Ik denk dat het zo bijzonder is omdat het heel erg tijdloos is. Als je door de gebouwen van Kahn loopt, dan zie je eigenlijk niets wat hoort bij een bepaalde mode of bij een bepaald soort trend of iets dergelijks. Maar je ziet eigenlijk dingen terug die je ook kan terugvinden in de gotische kathedralen van 1000 jaar geleden of in de Egyptische tempels van 3000 jaar geleden. De omgang met licht, de omgang met materiaal, de wijze waarop een wandeling door de ruimte wordt georganiseerd. De manier waarop je het materiaal kan aanraken en iets kan voelen, waarbij de hardste materialen opeens heel zacht overkomen. Hele fundamentele principes eigenlijk, waaruit blijkt dat het naast een architect ook gewoon een kunstenaar was. Nou, in deze tentoonstelling zie je eigenlijk die belangrijkste thema's in het werk van Louis Kahn terug. Gemeenschapsgevoel, landschap, het thuisgevoel. Je ziet dat terug aan de hand van origineel materiaal, dus maquettes, studies. Tekeningen, weinig foto's als afbeeldingen van, maar echt de originele materialen die de architect zelf in handen heeft gehad. En daardoorheen geweven eigenlijk allemaal impressies. Hij bleef proberen door middel van tekenen en schilderen greep te krijgen op de mooiste dingen die hij tegenkwam en daar ook iets mee te doen.
I think there's a gestation period when you are a creative person. You need to have those introverted times and those extroverted times. And also he was trained in the Beaux-Arts tradition, and then modern architecture just kind of emerged on the scene, and he tried to become part of that, and I think he learned a lot from that period, because it was a break with tradition, and so it almost freed the forms from their trappings of being old-fashioned. You know, it freed the forms so they could become
universal.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, the trappings fell away and the forms were there. And so it wasn't until that point in time, the early 50s, when he could put those things together in his own language and really come up with something that was art and that came beyond what was going on around him.
Right.
The current style.
The current style, yeah.
And sometimes people do that right away in life, you know, when they're 25. But for him, it just took that long before everything started to gel and, you know, you saw mature work. Hmm.
I think he thought of science and art as one thing. So I think perhaps he'd be pleased.
Yeah, this idea that light and material are one and the same thing, which of course Einstein thought of significantly before him, but still, you know, but Lou felt that. So I think your idea of the molecules there, you know,
I
there is this
felt that
feeling,
way.
Right?
You know, you just felt and perhaps he felt that way when he went to, let's say, the Pantheon in Rome, mm-hmm. that the structure spoke to you, or the space spoke to you and enfolded you and mm-hmm. made you a better human. I feel very proud to be connected to someone who changed life for the better through architecture, through art. I mean, I think that's a very powerful thing.
Yeah.
And I think this exhibit does a very wonderful idea of combining influences and science and words and images to show that. I think it's a wonderful exhibit.
Yeah, I think that's wonderfully said. Yeah.